Hi, welcome back to another video. Today we're talking about the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 6K Pro. It's bigger, it's fatter. Let's look into it.
Ooh, it's the BMP CC 6KP.
A lot of my stuff I've shot over the last 6 years, I've shot a ton of it Blackmagic. Shot a lot of other cameras as well, but Blackmagic's kind of been my go-to for a long time. So I was kind of excited to see the announcement of this camera. However, there was a few things that kind of bummed me out about it, and mostly it's the size and weight. Now I understand that you added a swivel screen, built-in NDs, which are awesome. But when I think of a pocket camera, I think of a pocket camera. This just keeps getting bigger. I feel like Blackmagic really just wanted to go head-to-head with the Canon C70. Anyway, some of the new added features, I'll go through them kind of quickly. Foldable screen that is way brighter. I did test it outside, bright daylight, and it actually is great. It adds an EVF to it. It also has a added battery grip that can be added to the bottom, as well as different batteries, which is the standard Sony NPF batteries. So they switched from the Canon to the Sony so that the battery would last about the same amount of time as it does on the 4K, because this eats up a lot more batteries. However, with the 6K, it does last a little bit longer than the regular 6K, the 6K Pro. But if you have the screen all the way up on the brightness, it lasts about the same amount of time. They did add another audio mini XLR jack on the side, which also takes phantom power. The one thing I wish they had done, because this is technically like the Pro version, I wish it was SDI and not HDMI. It's just a lot more solid of a connector. And a lot of my other gear with my Ursa is SDI. So I was like, you know, if you're going Pro, go Pro. Don't do this halvesies Pro.
No more half measures.
My initial thoughts on this camera is, okay, I guess. Built-in NDs are really nice. They're handy. It is quite a bit heftier than the 4K. Like, the 6K was a little bit heftier, but this just feels hefty. The ergonomics of it, like holding it, my wrist just started hurting after a while holding it all the time. So I think you need to build it out with the double handle rig and stuff. And then they talk about adding the extra battery pack. This thing is already kind of top heavy. Once you add this on top, it does get pretty, it gets pretty tall. I just feel like the taller a camera gets, the more unstable it gets. I like longer cameras versus taller cameras. And I think there's a weird trend right now of making these hybrid DSLR like taller and wider, and they just kind of feel awkward to me. I don't super love them. I think another thing that I noticed is it's a little wider here on the grip. It's not quite as easy to reach the buttons, like switching between ISO and shutter and white balance and all that. It didn't seem as easy as like with a 4K. I know it's kind of nitpicky, but you know, there's little things like that on cameras that I just really appreciate when it's thought out. And I think this was thought out, but I think it was just like, hey, we need to cram ND filters and have a flippable screen and make sure that the battery lasts a little longer. How do we do that? Oh, we gotta make it thicker. Well, you did it, and it's thicker, and it is.
It's a camera, I guess.
I remember when I first got my T2i, it just was easy, it was fun to shoot with, and it didn't feel like I had anything holding me back. It just became part of me. It was like, it's like sucked into my chest and I became part of it. It was like symbiotic relationship with my camera. I just didn't get that same feeling, you know? It's like you go on a date with a girl and you're just like, it's just really hard to say. I just don't think it's gonna work out. I know. You have 12-bit RAW, just immaculate, amazing footage, dual ISO, built-in NDs. You even got two little mounting points on the bottom. It's so cute. But if it's not right, it's not right. And yeah, I just don't like you.
And then the viewfinder is kind of a nice add-on. I didn't super love shooting with it. I just felt like it just kind of was a little awkward. And for some reason, looking down like this, I don't know why, it just got me a little motion sick for some reason. I know that's weird, but I don't know. Wasn't my favorite. The brightness of the screen is actually my favorite part. Looking at it outside is quite nice.
The Pocket 4K, that is the biggest downfall, is it's hard to always see the screen in really bright daylight. This screen, I had no problem. Middle of the day, super bright, I could see it just fine. And then, of course, if you needed to, you had the EVF, which I think is silly, but somebody probably loves it. What else can I say about it? I don't know. What else do you want to hear? Did I cover enough? Do you guys even care? I mean, there's like 6 billion reviews out there on this camera, and I feel like all of them are like, oh my word, this thing is great. Look at this. Like, for this amount of money, what else could you ask for? And yeah, I mean, they're not wrong. I've talked a lot of trash about this camera. It's actually a really great camera. 12-bit RAW. The Gen 5 color space is awesome, which, by the way, came onto the 4K as well, which is, thank you, Blackmagic. You're actually updating older cameras still. This is a really amazing camera. Built in for the price, $2,500. Yeah, it's crazy. If you're in the market for a camera and you're like, oh, I have $2,500 to spend, this might be a great choice. Might be the choice you're looking for. For me, I just like shooting with it. And a lot of the stuff is like, do I enjoy shooting with the camera? Because that's what I do all the time, is shoot with the camera. And if I don't enjoy doing that, there's so many other options out there. And this wasn't for me. You know, if it's not for you, it's not for you. Anyway, I hope this was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe and check out my other videos. Also, I am not putting ads on my videos anymore. So subscribe, because you won't have to watch stupid pre-roll ads that are super annoying, because they're always the same ones over and over again.